There we go. Two slices of delicious cake. Absolutely what I needed.
Watch more Operation Ouch on BBC iPlayer.
There you go.
How did it look like it was going?
To be honest, Chris, I think the date is going really well. They seem to get along and they are perfectly matched. I've had a bit of a think about this. Snowperson and Minizand both love cats. They love sunset walks on the beach and they both enjoy exactly the same television program.
Operation Ouch.
No, horrible histories.
Well, at any rate, it warms my heart to see them getting along so well. They certainly seem to have a bit of chemistry, which makes me think that we could talk a little bit about the chemistry of love.
So love's actually quite mysterious. There's a lot that we don't understand. We can't predict love. We don't really know why it happens. And when it does happen to you, it can feel like a lot to deal with all at once. It's a lot of complicated emotions.
And when we talk about brain chemicals, we really mean stuff called neurotransmitters. Now these are chemicals that are released from one nerve cell and they travel across a little tiny gap and they meet another nerve cell and they send a chemical message from one nerve cell to another.
Now, there are lots of different kinds of neurotransmitters in your brain, but in love, the two that we think are really important are dopamine and oxytocin.
Waiter, can we get our food now, please?
All right, mate, the food's on the way. Honestly, Chris, the service in this restaurant is terrible.
Oh, look, Minizand is giving Snowperson a card.
It's got the little heart symbol on it. Oh. So look, you see the symbol on the card that Minizand's just handed over? The heart shape, you think it's heart shaped, but it's not really heart shaped, is it? So where does it come from?
I don't know.
It's possible it's just a simple anatomical drawing of a heart, because a heart has two sides,
and
if you cut a heart in half...
It's a bit like that.
Looks a bit like that.
I'll buy that.
Okay, the other idea is that the ancient Greeks and Romans admired a kind of fennel plant that had seed pods that looked a bit like the heart symbol, and they thought that this was associated with kind of love and romance. Sorry, I'll get the food. Where's that food?
Of course, it's not just the messages we send and the language we use. You can also tell a lot about how a thing is going from looking at their body language.
And their body language is definitely suggesting they are getting on well. They're leaning in, they're sort of chatting to one another. When you really like someone, your body language changes in some ways that are probably quite obvious. You might want to look at them or smile at them or be near them, even hold their hand. But there are some things that we tend to do subconsciously, and one of those things is mirroring. So you might start to mirror someone's gestures that they're making while they're talking to you. You might start to mirror the tone of their voice or the way they're nodding their head. Are you mirroring me? You're meant to do it subconsciously. He's only doing it because he likes me.
Xand, I think the body language has changed a bit. I'm not sure the date is going so well. They seem to be gesturing angrily. Oh, wait a minute. They're gesturing angrily at us.
It's time for pudding.
Oh, they want pudding. The most important part of any Valentine's Day meal. Pudding, please. There we go. Two slices of delicious cake.
Absolutely what I needed.
Watch more Operation Ouch on BBC iPlayer.
I think I'd better get them a customer feedback form.
I'm going to need another two slices.